thank you to your dogs. It's unbelievable what a difference that makes. Very good girl. Easy. Now, when you say no begging, she gets the word begging. Okay. And it's so hard for us to get that. But it's a common understanding in, you know, in psychology. There's no picture of no. So, you want her to beg?
No.
Okay. easy girl. What a good dog. Yes. So we need to ask her to, can you sit please?
Joy, can you sit please?
And now give her the treat. What a good dog. That's really nice. That's such a good dog. And I just want her to have an opportunity with us here. And this, you need a treat now. We need chocolate for you. Because it's hard being in front of everyone. And just, it's a great gift. Easy girl, easy. Of course she does. Now this is nice. She turned and looked at you all. Now wagged her tail. That was really a good dog. That's a good girl. Now she looked at me. What? Yeah, she looked at me, wondered who am I? What am I doing here? And this opportunity. What? Yeah. Good girl. That's very nice. Excellent. Good lady. That's nice. Good girl, Joy. What a good dog. So I look at her and I look away. Look at her and I look away. I lick my lips. I pay attention to my, you know, where I'm standing. Joy. Joy. Would you like to come over? Oh, what a good dog. Yes. That's a very good dog. Now I just let my fingers wander on her neck, behind her ear. That's a very good girl. On her shoulder. Now I let my thumb do a little circle. Let her move away. Let her think about that. And I really pay attention to the quality of my voice, because what I'm doing is to consciously be in heart coherence. That has to do with the tone and the timbre and how I stand. If I lock my knees, I cannot be in this relaxed state if I tighten any of my joints. So I'm consciously aware of what I do with my whole movement of my body. This is an invitation for her. What a good dog. Now, could you just bring her up just a little? And I'm going to have you show us and just run your hand. It's a good girl. You can just run your hand over her whole body and show us what you've been doing, because you've been doing T-Touch on her, right?
Yes, I have.
So let's see what you've been doing. This is very nice. Good girl. And I pay attention to the quality of my voice. I really don't keep, you know, focused on her. It's really helpful to me to have all of you here, as opposed to if you're with a client, I defocus my attention and just keep the whole repet. And see her looking at me? Interesting. That was very nice.
And Linda, I notice that every time you make eye contact with her, your eyes are smiling.
Yes.
Which, you know, really softens her.
And that really takes practice. It's a practice thing. It's not a natural. That's very nice. That's nice. And Sonia, how is your breath?
I'm very conscious in practicing breathing.
Okay. So what we haven't talked about is the concept. One of the ways, and some of you may have different styles of breathing. What I've done, and I've been practicing this for more than 30 years, is like breathing in through my nose and just out softly through pursed lips. And what I'm visualizing as I do this, like not every time, but what I keep in mind, I'm wanting to oxygenate and fill out these little lung balloons. If you Google alveoli, it's like there are millions of these little lung balloons to get oxygen. And that's what I'm at. This is in the back of my mind when I breathe in this way. Without blowing on the dog. That's a trick. You have to pay attention. You're laughing, Marnie. Have you ever done that with you?
I have, and I'm thinking of Sophia Yin, especially because we were just looking at her poster. Sophia Yin had a Jack Russell who, if breathed upon, would bite.
Oh.
And she has this extensive, you know, work with the Jack Russell to help him feel differently about that.
So. Nice. Hey, girl, would you like to come up? That's a girl. Oh, that's very nice. Now, can you come in front of Sonia? You ask her to come? You can just ask her to. And now I'd like her to sit and have you start doing some touches on her. Good girl.
Joy, could you sit, please?
Good girl. Thank you.
That's nice. Good lady. Good. Now you've just done like three circles in one spot. So just do a circle and a quarter and a little slide. And I like to run down like from the shoulders down along the side of the back. It's actually on the bladder meridian on either side of the spine. That's nice. Just on down the side. No, not on right on the spine. You, first of all, you can, while she's sitting, it's nice to, just to slide your hand down. Good girl. That's very nice. That's good. This is really good. That's nice. Good lady. And I'm notice how I'm sitting slightly sideways, not facing her. That's a girl. And I work to pay attention to where my hands are going. This takes practice, but I really run a line down parallel to the spine. Parallel to the spine.
Parallel.
And so for where your position, where you are, it's a little, just shift the harness to the middle of her back. Good. And then it's easier where you are, I think, if you reach across to the other side and just start on the shoulders and then run a line back along. That's nice. And a little slide. Good girl. That's nice. She wants to see who's here. Nice. That's really good. Now, I'm using my voice in a very particular way. I slow down the words. So when I'm connecting with her, I have to, if I'm talking like this, what do you think it's going to be? What happens to her breath? And to all of yours. So the tempo of the voice affects every key touch that you do. That's nice. Good. And this is really nice. And you can do like your circle and a quarter and then a little lift. Add the little lift to that. A lift to the skin, actually. Circle and a quarter, and you just bring, just lift the skin up a little bit. That's like our coiled python. Good girl. And what pressure do you think you're using?
Probably a three. I think I've gone a little deeper.
It's a lot, isn't it? Right. So try a lighter one. It looks like a three. You can't tell for sure, though, when a person, that's why I asked you. So I would just do a two. You're just moving the skin. Huh? That's nice. And that's a nice little slide. Good girl. So I lick my lips when she looks at me. She's, did you see her blink there? Before her eyes were pretty open, weren't they?
She just looked back at you.
And then when she was first looking at me, did you see how open the eyes were? And when I licked my lips and blinked away, now once she gets, that's very nice. Now she's asking right there for a little more connection. So I have to be really conscious of that. I'll give it to her for a second. I acknowledge her differently. And then I still look away. I want her to feel really comfortable because where my gaze goes is where my energy goes. And I want the energy to be with these two. That's really nice. What a great dog. Yes, that's a girl. Now, if you can go down from starting to the from the front on the side. And now this is where the back of the fingers really works, either just the back of the fingernails, that first section, with the, you know, baby chimp, because that's kind of easy. Or you might use from the tip to the second joint, whatever is comfortable for you, or the side, just whatever is comfortable from that side. That's really nice. Look at her watching you all now. She's interested in you all. What a great dog. Joy, you are such a great dog. Really nice. That's beautiful. Now add a little slide. What I'd like to invite you to do, imagine that you've kind of got your dog there with you. So you do a circle and a quarter, little pause, and a little slide. 2 or 3 inches, parallel to the spine. The more conscious you are, the more it's going to affect her. And you're using chimp now.
Oh, you wanted me to take it, that I
You're using chimp right there, right?
Yes.
Can you open your fingers a little more so they're a little softer, as in the baby orang? Chimp is a little hard. Try it. Just reach out, and just from the first joint to the second, make that movement and see, like, I can feel a tightening in my muscles, in my ribs. Open your fingers. Can you feel it release? Can you feel a difference in release? I can feel it in this. That's nice. Yeah, and then a slide. Circle and a quarter, and a slide to the next spot, parallel to the spine. Yeah, nice. Good girl. Do a little longer slide. You can just set a couple of, like, 2 inches or so. The slide is the connector. We haven't spoken about the connectors. That slide is as important in a way as a circle. It's different. But what it does is, my message is, here, feel this. Feel yourself.
Feel that.
And you see how important it is that she actually have a pillow? This wouldn't be nearly as effective for her if she didn't have something to rest her chin on. It's just perfect. That's a girl. Now, what I like to do next, and the position you're in, you're going to have to do it with your left hand. It's a little challenging with the harness, but this is where I put my thumb on the side next on your side, and then I take my fingers and I just, with a 2 contact, not anymore. I do a circle and a quarter, a little pause, and a little slide along both sides of the spine. About, see how far apart my fingers are. That's true. That's what we're doing. That's very good. That's a girl. Little slide. A slide parallel to the spine. Now, the reason I say parallel to the spine, you have to figure out what that is. You have to stay present and logical. So this is a connection. This is a combination, you all, of feeling and logically knowing where you're going. And you're going to stay on that side away from you. You're going to run that line all the way. And I'm just giving her a sense of her body just with my fingers on the side away from me all the way. That's a girl.
Yeah, she's turning that side away from me.
Well, she may also just be relaxing. And it may be that you're a little too hard, and she's not quite sure what you're doing. So now, so she's moved away. Now I take like the back of my fingers, and I just, Joy, that's a girl. That's a very good girl. Let me just show her that. That's nice. That's really good. Yeah. Now I use like my finger tips. Like the little bear touch in there. Oh, that's good. So when she looks at me, I acknowledge her. Back of my fingers on the side of her cheek here, and a nice little slide on her ears. Good girl. That's nice. That's a girl. Now, I'm going to do this kind of like this little tantalizing troika. Use the back of my fingers when I get down to her tail. I want to see how does she feel about that. Now I'm using a two combination. If you can't see, you guys, you can come out here. You don't have to get in.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
The troika.
Yes.
Is the whole troika a slide, or are the circles like regular
circle circles? And a half circle. Circle and a half circle.
Do we move connected the skin in that?
What?
Do we move the skin in the
sometimes
troika?
Yes, sometimes no. With
okay,
the tantalizing troika,
okay, yeah.
It's just the hair.
Okay.
With the... And see, I can't use my fingers in my position. My fingers like this. Why? It's too direct. That's why I'm turning my hand over. Now, when I do this very gentle whispering to her, really quietly, that helps me stay in heart coherence. It helps me continue to breathe as I do that. That's really nice. Yes, girl. Yes, yes. Good girl. So I'm making circle, and then I keep going down. It's kind of a little variation of the troika. Nice. I just want to see. I haven't gone down yet to the pants all the way down. She's just kind of getting acquainted with me. That's really nice. That's good. Now I'm going to start doing this movement. Thumb and forefinger. It's like just over the skin. Nice. That's a girl. Just doing a couple of them. She's, yeah, that's a girl. That's nice. What do you think of that? And I give her time to think about her. This is where the pauses in between are so valuable. Did you hear?